Welcome. Let's talk about some of the key things that have been discussed in this edition of Down to Earth. So to begin with, the organic farming in the regions of Tamil Nadu. Now using natural fertilizers, pesticides and soil manure, multi-cropping and crop rotations have been done and it has increased the crop yield and the income for the farmers. The next is Pradhan Mantri Jan Arogya Yojana, a coverage of 5 lakh per family per year to be provided, the poorest household to be identified, but so far it was believed that till 2021 only 17.5% of the poorest households were registered and 0.99 million beneficiaries registered against the 3 dummy mobile numbers, which actually are the dummy numbers. As you can see, there have been various beneficiaries which have been issued the same identification number, so who would get the benefits for those are again questionable. Ill-equipped hospital, there are certain criteria that you need to fulfill once they are registered under the Jan Arogya Yojana. So if we talk about those criteria, that must have over-the-clock pharmacy, blood bank, laboratory, dialysis unit, post-operative ICU and some others as well. Fire safety measures, standard practice for treatment. Then if we talk about Bihar, there are only 1.8 hospitals per lakh population. For Rajasthan, it's just 3 hospitals. The hospital availability is extremely low in most of the states. Even for Andaman and Nicobar, we have seen that people are flying to regions in Chennai and nearby areas because they are not getting all the facilities which are offered under the Jan Arogya Yojana, which are covered under the Jan Arogya Yojana in the regions of Andaman and Nicobar. So additional developments need to be taken into account. The next is flood proof Himalayas. Now spatial planning needs to be done in such a way that Hindu Kush Himalayan mountains become climate resilient. We have seen a huge amount of landslides in recent, and also the low-lying districts have been recently affected. For example, the Bangladesh Bandarban area in Chittagong is one of the worst affected. There were floods which submerged 80% of the Bandarban's municipal expanse, and it had proved a kind of havoc for the region. There are various flood situations because of rapid urbanization, higher developments in the field of dams and technology which are developed, and therefore you need to take into account that how the planning needs to be taken into account. So participatory technology based spatial planning of land use is one such ways in which we can actually counterpart these. Again, looking on to the climate change, the floods and the landslides, there has to be change in the development. The GIS and the earth observation data must be taken into account. The images from those must be taken into account. Satellite techniques must be considered. And then we also talk about International Center for Integrated Mountain Development located in Kathmandu. Now this talks about how local communities can safeguard their environment and their own livelihood. There are broad range of actions with the trees being planted in the riverbanks in the nearby areas. The next important concern is leopards. The population of leopards has been going drastically. We have seen a significant jump in the population of recent, specifically in the regions of Maharashtra and Gujarat. So far, it was considered under endangered category. So the idea now is to actually have sterilization program to control the rising growth of the population of leopards. So there has been a report which is known as Status of Leopards, Co-Predators and Mega Herbivores. Maharashtra nearly has 1690 leopards, the fourth highest after Madhya Pradesh, Gujarat and Karnataka. Also, we need to understand that water availability and the region which are irrigation intensive are to be checked in. So for example, sugarcane, pomegranate and grapes are the areas which require water intensive crops, and because they are water intensive crops, they are again dense vegetation, which is very good for the breeding of leopards in the region. Now recently, as I said, from the past 6 years, 2/3 of the individual per square kilometer has grown to 6 to 7. So from 2 to 3 in 1 square kilometer, in 100 square kilometer, it's now 6 to 7 in 100 square kilometers. So population has more than doubled in the last 6 years, and therefore we need to understand. Also, the survival chances in the semi-urban, rural and sugarcane areas are extremely high. This has also caused numerous human fatalities and human deaths in the regions of Maharashtra and Gujarat. And not only in this region, even in the regions of Uttarakhand, there have been significant effect because of this. The next is Biodiversity Act amendment. Now, according to this, the local Ved community and Hakims are exempted from the provisions. However, the others have to take into account for any kind of extraction for commercial utilization, and that can be done only with a prior intimation that has to be taken into account. Also, the benefit sharing has to be between the local and the national authorities. The next is protecting the intellectual property rights. So, as per the new rules, the approval is required only before the grant of patents. The next is digital data protection. Now, digital data protection has to be taken very seriously, and government in 2023 itself brought in two provisions for which are considered to be the weakening structures for the RTI, which was released in 2005. Now, it exempts all personal information. That's one of the clauses that we need to understand. And also, it has amended to ensure that all information which can be related to person can now be denied. So, two of these are really important to understand. There are various other exemptions that the list of those have been cited here, mainly pertaining to the privacy of an individual, which are not related to public activity or unwarranted invasion of the privacy. Also, the next is the rising food inflation. Recently, we have seen that the food inflation has retained to 6% and above, which is a significant range. And the consumer food price index rose by 11%. And this has been the highest since October 2020. There has been overall increase in the consumer price index by 7.44%, which is again a significant level. Now, these price hikes are related to numerous phenomena. Ukraine-Russia war is one of those. The next is the climate change. Also, the areas being destroyed by floods, landslides, extreme weather conditions, droughts in certain areas, lack of monsoons are again important. The next is how we can actually handle this rising food inflation is through hybrid takeover. So hybrid seeds are getting popular. Fiji virus infection can actually reduce the height of most of the crops. Now, in the Ambala districts, there are hybrid seed manufactured by Bayer, which is a German company, and which this seed can actually catch the infection very easily. The idea of hybrid seeds have been growing significantly. There are open pollinated varieties of the seed. There are hand-picked varieties of the seeds. Also, the private companies are increasing the share of seed market, and this has become important. Lurdu village in Kunti has a local wheat variety which is known as Godadhan, and this grows even in an area where there is extreme water shortage. So even there are some varieties which can bring in drastic change. Similarly, there are hybrid varieties of bajra, which is pearl millet. Mustard seeds with hybrid varieties can go up to 1000 per kg. In reality, it costs nearly 80 per kg. So there has been again a huge gap in the range as well. But with the hybrid varieties, you have better yields, 20 to 30% higher yields, changes in the seed quality, and also changes in the use of the fertilizers and the pesticides with the hybrid plants. The next is rainwater harvesting. Now, rainwater harvesting is a very important aspect, specifically in the region where dry areas are seen. So, Rajasthan, where harsh desert conditions are seen and less than 300 millimeters of annual rainfall is seen. In that case, rainwater harvesting is one of the major things that need to be taken into account. So, Western Rajasthan has received nearly 70% of the annual rainfall, but the entire state is in terms of the excess rainfall which has been received this year. So, this structures actually bring in water harvesting to its best. So, Sendra village in Rajasthan, which is a newly formed district from Biavar, is actually one of the areas where Aravallis have a rain shadow area with less than 500 millimeters, and there are various water structures. These are known as talab, nadi, tanka, and they are where the houses collect the water. Now, there have been various traditional units which have been there and projects under MNREGA which have been created. Similarly, in the Bar village, there are numerous burns and which are created, any cuts which are created in the region. Nearly 3,000 traditional water harvesting systems have been built. Ramsar village in Barmer is another such example, which has numerous ponds which are there, badis are there, and nearly 2,500 traditional water harvesting structures are there. Madasar village is there, where in 2 months itself, 155 ponds have been constructed. It is attributed to severe drought conditions. And then you have Jaisindh village, Sanvata village, which is there. You also have Rupwas village in Pali, Chandadniya in Barmer. So these are some of the examples, and you can see in the picture here how the rainfall patterns are seen. But with this fluctuating rainfall patterns, with the rainwater harvesting systems being built, there have been efficient utilization of water, because every drop of water counts. This water which has been stored can become part of the Jal Jeevan Mission, providing water supply on a daily per capita domestic basis. Also, the traditional water system is another important aspect that would be taken into account. Some other important things which were discussed in the Down to Earth edition this time was the descendant of Omicron, the Iris, which has been recently identified. The Maui Island in Hawaii recently witnessed a kind of wildfire in the Lahania town. This was considered as one of the worst disasters in the last 100 years. There have been very high heavy rainfalls in the regions of Uttarakhand and Himachal Pradesh. Uzbekistan, we have seen a huge number of deaths which is related to the cough syrup being supplied from India. There are again reports on clean energy and reducing the use of coal. There have been a high development in the field of renewable sources of energy. And then energy transition through the Just Energy Transition Partnership, which has been secured funding from nearly 9 developed nations led by US and Japan, is again an important development. So those were some of the important aspects that we have discussed today. In case you have any questions or queries, feel free to post us in the comment section or email us to admin@examraise.com. Thanks for joining in today.